burns on me, Benson. Nobody. What the hell is going on here, huh? Stupid frogs. Supposed to be protecting me.
Appelez l'ambulance et dites-leur de passer par l'entrée de service.
Hey, I told you. Talk English around me. I hate it when you talk this frog talk.
I was just telling him to get an ambulance for the officer. His wound is serious.
The hell with him! I'm the guy you're supposed to be taking care of, remember?
If you'll just calm down.
Calm down. Calm down. You said I'd be safe here while you fixed it to get me a new face. So what happens? I'm not here 10 seconds, and some lousy roach tries to whack me in the hall.
It was me he was shooting at.
Too bad he missed. Look, take me out of this joint now, okay? Now, I want to see your doctor.
It is not that simple, Mr. Benson.
No. Well, make it that simple. Otherwise, I'm going to start singing about what you and your new friend Palazzo are up to.
Palazzo was killed by a car bomb in the States.
Oh! You agreed to print that story about Palazzo if he'd come here to give evidence for you. I know you boys are planning some big-time busts, but you need Palazzo for that. Alive. So what do you say?
All right. We'll do it your way. For now.
Now you're being smart. I like that.
Marked for death. Augie Benson needs a new identity. He's about to find out that becoming another means more than just changing your name or the way you look.
Tell me about this Dr. Ray.
Dr. Renault is one of the most respected surgeons in France. She's worked with us many times.
You mean a dame? I don't trust dames. They're always flapping their gums at the wrong time.
You can trust her.
You better be right.
Monsieur Labrou.
Hello. I'm Gary Dupri, Dr. Renault's assistant. And you must be Mr. Benson.
But you can just call me Augie, honey.
If you'll follow me. Mr. Benson, this way.
Welcome to the Institute, Mr. Benson. I trust Carrie has told you something about our methods.
What I want to know is when do I get my new face?
I'm afraid we don't allow smoking here, Mr. Benson. It's one of our strictest rules.
Well, then you can consider me to be an exception to the rules.
I really must insist. Carrie.
You were saying? I get my new face when?
I'm afraid the procedure is not that simple. Here at the Institute, we feel that cosmetic surgery is only one step toward a much larger process, lifestyle adjustment. We must first evaluate your needs, determine your suitability for any number of treatment courses.
What is this, LeBro? I thought we had a done deal.
Please sit down, Mr. Benson.
I want my new face, and I want it now, so cut the crap!
I'm afraid if that's your attitude, we can't help you. Carrie, please show Mr. Benson out.
Who the hell do you think you are, lady? Look, my butt's in a sling, so you damn well better help. Otherwise, I'm gonna shove this desk down your stinking throat.
Take it easy, Ogie. You're not doing yourself any good. Let me talk to her.
Yeah, well, talk good, cop, or they'll be fishing Palazzo out of the river. You hear me?
Mademoiselle Dupree, if you don't mind, I would like to talk to the doctor alone.
I'm sorry, Mr. LeBro. I simply cannot take on a patient as violent as Mr. Benson. The man is a psychopath.
They all are, Doctor. That's why we bring them here, in the first place.
This one's different. He's far too dangerous. I can't have him threatening my staff, the other patients. Imagine what might happen if we lost control of him.
Imagine what would happen if the government discontinued your funding. What would happen to your research?
So when do we do it, Doc?
Just a few more tests.
You've been saying that to me for a week now. I'm getting sick of this place.
You must try to be a little patient, Mr. Benson. Full facial surgery is a very complex procedure.
You wouldn't be playing me for a sucker now, would you, Doc?
No, of course not. It's just that these things take time.
You know how simple it is to snap a person's neck?
Dr. Baudin is here to see you.
Carrie, I want Mr. Benson transferred to Block 6 tomorrow.
Block 6, but what about...
Mr. Benson is very anxious to begin his procedure, and I think we've done enough testing. That is what you want, isn't it, Mr. Benson?
You bet.
I'll arrange the staff.
That's the way they're gonna do it, huh?
Yes.
Let's have a look.
No, Mr. Benson, it's not possible.
Why not?
It's a restricted area. I don't have authorization. Please, Mr. Benson, you need your rest.
Yeah, sure.
If there's anything else you need, just ring.
Hold on.
Yes?
I'm a little nervous, you know.
Oh, there's no reason to be. Dr. Renault is an excellent surgeon.
Well, I thought that maybe you would... help me to unwind.
Well, I don't know what you mean. No, no, please. Don't.
Enjoy yourself.
No, let me go.
Bonjour. Comment allez-vous ce matin? Bonjour. Comment allez-vous ce matin? What are you doing here?
You should have seen him. It was like she cut their brain out or something.
What are you talking about?
I want out. You understand? This place, it's not right.
I thought you wanted a new face.
I changed my mind.
What about your friends? If they find you, you know what will happen.
I'll take my chances.
I don't know. I don't have the authority to make this kind of decision. I have to call my supervisors.
Yeah, I know. Look, I need your help. I need a passport and some cash. Can you meet me? Yeah, tonight. The old warehouse. I'll be there in a few hours. Okay.
move nice and slow, okay? There's a few things your former employer would like to ask you while you're still alive. So be very careful. I wouldn't want to disappoint Palazzo if I were you.
Okay, don't shoot.
Oh.
Nobody burns Augie Benson. Nobody.
Surgery, of course. Dr. Renault's waiting.
Wait a minute.
No need to worry. It will be over before you know it, and you'll be a brand new person.
Where's LeBro? I have to talk to LeBro.
Just relax.
Wait! Wait! Wait. Wait! You can't do this. You can't do this to me! You can't do this to me. You can't get away with this. I won't let you get away with this. You can't do this to me! Nobody burns Augie Benson. You won't get away with this. Nobody burns Augie Benson. I'll get you. I'll get all of you!
Oh, no, Mr. Benson. The only thing you will get is peace.
You can't do this to me! Nobody burns Augie Benson.
As I told you when you first came here, we believe in total readjustment.
No!
Not just
no,
a new face.
No, no,
new soul.
No.
One free of violence and oppression. Gentlemen, you may shave his head.
In a few days, we'll be able to start his cosmetic surgery. In a few months, he'll have his new face. He'll be a whole new person on the outside.
And on the inside?
It's a little trickier. This sort of psychosurgery is somewhat radical. But I think we were completely successful. Augie, look who's come to see you.
Mr. LeBro, good morning. How are you?
Just fine, Augie. And you?
Couldn't be better. Isn't it a beautiful day today?
Augie Benson needed to become someone else, and eventually understood what it meant to make that change. Although initially a little reluctant, Augie's a new man now. Couldn't be happier.
Thank you.